Test, test.
That's better.
Good morning. I guess you guys like it when there's a chill in the air, huh? Morning, ladies. All right, so we are going to start on our hands and knees. So in a tabletop pose. So just kind of settle in. Hi, Carol. Good morning. Try to line up your knees right under your hips and your hands right under your shoulders. So for those of you that are practicing at home or that tune into this recording on another day at home, I apologize beforehand because I'm going to create some heat this morning in our bodies because it's about 64 degrees out. That's a little bit lower than normal temperature for doing yoga. So, and a little cool for Florida. So we're going to create just a little bit of heat, and all it takes to create heat in your body is muscle action. So as we sit here, or kneel here, in our tabletop pose, imagine that your hands were pressing down into the mat, but they were isometrically squeezing toward each other. As they squeeze in, you might feel the chest broaden, and you might feel the arms engage, right? That's what muscle action feels like. So it's these subtle little things. Our hands push down, but they squeeze in a little. And then I want you to press your shins down and the tops of your feet down and try to squeeze them apart or spread them apart. Can you feel that now? So it's the same pose, but it has a completely different feeling to it. That's it. Now try to keep those actions in the hands and in the shins and pull the belly button to the spine so your ribs aren't hanging, right? We want to hold a little bit of support from the abdominal wall, so that's supporting the spine. And now the hardest part of all of this is to have all three of those actions happening in harmony. So check in with yourself. This is subtle work. Check in and make sure that you're not doing one any more than the others, and that one doesn't slip away while you're focused on another one. So we're active throughout the body. To me, this is consciousness over effort, and this is what our yoga is about. Starting to think and be present and fully aware of what we're doing when we're doing it. Now, we're going to keep all of these actions, but we're going to tuck our toes under and lift the knees an inch or two. Now, there should be no space under your fingers. Your hands should be flat. If there's space under your knuckles or your fingers, that means you have too much weight in your wrists and you want to distribute the weight out fully into a flat palm print. Press out through your fingers, press the knuckles down. Yeah, we're using everything we got and we're using it equally. Now, we still feel the hands squeezing, we still feel the legs widening, and we feel the belly drawing to the spine. Now, we've been doing this so long that it's starting to get annoying, right? Good. Now breathe. It will change everything. It gives you an attitude adjustment. And then take one inhale, and as you exhale, push back slowly to downward facing dog. Can you still feel the actions in your hands and your legs and your belly? Right? We got to feel a little bit of that muscle activation. And we'll maintain that feeling of muscle activation as we come forward into plank pose. So we come forward into plank. Hands squeeze a little, feet spread a little bit, belly drawing in. Try not to let the hips sag. It's as if you have space under you that you can feel. That space is under there supporting you. Good. Now come really high on your toes, bend your knees, and put your knees back down onto the mat. Good. Sink back to child's pose. Now you can let go of all of that muscle activation and soften. In every practice, there should be an equal amount of hard and soft. And little by little, we're going to start shedding layers of clothes, I'm sure. That's okay. Just keep at least one layer on. All right, come forward into your tabletop. See if you can find the even actions in the body. Tuck your toes, come into your floating tabletop. We'll take one nice deep breath in and exhale back into downward facing dog, checking in to make sure the actions are still existing in the body. Take another deep breath and then exhale forward into plank. Again, feeling that the body is still in sync. We'll inhale here and then bend the elbows and lower down slowly. Come a little forward as you lower. And then lay onto the belly, point your toes back, and inhale into cobra. This is the first real action in the spine. So you're going to feel the muscles in your back body contract a little bit. And I want you to feel an openness and a softness across the chest. Don't overwork your arms. Use your arms to enhance the work. Let's take one more breath here. And then exhale, release, let it back down. Tuck your toes. We're going to push straight up into plank. Push up to plank, tip your hips back, and go to down dog. Very nice. Are you guys starting to feel a little heat? A little bit? All right. Inhale again. Push back a little. Feel the hands, feel the core, feel your legs. Mindful actions in the body. And now on your inhale, let's lift the right leg up in the air behind us. We'll start using the large muscles. Yeah. So the leg lifts on the inhalation, and then come to plank and squeeze your knee to your belly on the exhalation. That's so good. Take it back in the air, inhale, and this time step it through to your hands. Good. Rise into high crescent lunge. The arms sweep up over the head. It feels a little bit like the hands squeeze in. They squeeze into the space. The legs press out. Feel weight in the pinky toes. And the core activates into the center line. See if you can feel all of that happening. So your legs are alive, your core is stable, and your arms are active. Take one more breath. Lean back a little. It'll give you a little bit of a right? And then exhale, put your hands on the floor. Step back lightly to plank. And once again, we lower onto the belly. Inhale for cobra pose. And then exhale back to down dog. Stay present in your body. Stay active with your breathing. All right, now, left leg rises on the inhale. We're going to come forward to plank and squeeze the knee to the elbow on the exhale. Ooh, squeeze that air out. And then inhale, sweep the leg back up in the air. This time, step it forward. Keep it near your left hand. All right, rise up on the inhalation. Feel the feet ground down and out. Feel the arms squeeze in, as if you had like a basketball in your hands and you were kind of squeezing it there up over your head. And then you feel the core activate. The belly draws to the spine. You create your own stability. And all of it's happening in sync. Not one is happening more than the others. Take one more breath here. We're going to lean back a touch just to feel it. And then place those hands down onto the floor. Step to plank and lower. Inhale for cobra. Let the heart feel a little soft. And then exhale, down dog. All right. I like the way you're moving. You guys starting to feel a little bit better, a little warm? All right. Inhale, push back. And then exhale, look at your hands. Let's walk our feet right up to the top of the mat. Bring the feet together here. Inhale, come halfway up, and exhale, fold. Now, with the feet together, fingertips on the floor, bend your knees. Bend them low. See if you can get your hips down almost as low as your knees are. And then let go of that grip your fingers have on the floor and start to sweep your arms over your head. See if you can do this with your heels flat. So there's a place there where you're not in gravity. Put your heels down so you sit up a little higher. Yeah, there, that's better. A little more muscle work, but that's what we're doing today, yeah? You guys feel that? Now, arms by your sides. Lower your chest over your knees and reach your arms behind you. See if you can get your arms higher than your body. I love it. You guys are looking forward, and your hips are reaching back, and you're lifting the arms so high that you can now clasp them together behind you. Give me one inhale, and then exhale, fold in. Head dives down, legs begin to straighten. Ah. Breathe. See how much space you can create in the back of the legs without having too much tension. See if you can let the crown of your head down so there's no wrinkles in the back of your neck. And then really gently, let's shake the head, yes. Just gently, shake it, yes. Yes, I love yoga. And then shake it, no. No, I am not going to be distracted. All right, let's soften the knees, let the arms go. When you're ready, with a flat back, rise all the way to standing. Start to sweep your arms up to the sky. And then draw your hands right into the heart. All right, here we go. Feet are together. Inhale, arms reach. Exhale, forward fold. Belly in as you make the transition. Lift halfway, lengthen your spine. Now go to plank and lower. Both feet go back, hands squeeze, feet spread. Lower slow. Inhale, cobra. Feel the muscle actions. And as you go to down dog, belly stays into the spine. All right, take a breath. Push back a little. As you exhale, step the right foot forward to the right hand. Turn the left foot in flat. Warrior one. Ground down into your feet. Rise up facing forward to the best of your ability. That's it. Oh my God, you guys look amazing. Make sure that there's no collapse in the arch of your back foot. It's dangerous for the back knee. So we want the back foot flat, back heel down, but the arch of the foot lifted. So you feel weight in the pinky toe side of that back foot. Yep. Some of us are not used to using the pinky toe. We don't even think about our poor little pinky toes, right? But right now, those lateral borders of the feet are so strong, they'll hold you. All right, take another breath. Bend into the front knee a little deeper and then stretch back for the fullest expression and then let it go. Hands come down. Step back lightly and lower. You love this show? Yeah. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, down dog. The music is so good on this show. I watch it and all I think about is I gotta download this for yoga. All right, left foot steps up to the hands, right foot turns in flat. It's warrior one, rise up. Let's come up like we mean it. You can feel it. The hands are squeezing in, the feet are pressing out to the pinky toes, the core is drawing to the belly. All of these things are happening. It's like this feeling of integration. We're in control of our movements. We are making the shapes. The shapes are not making us. Now, bend into that front knee just a little deeper. Take a breath. Reach back a little further. And then exhale. Let's flow. Hands go down. Step back lightly and lower. Inhale for cobra. We're starting to get a groove. Exhale. Down dog. Let's take a really big inhale and let out a big old ah. Nicely done. Look at your hands. Start to walk your feet up to the top of the mat. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Bend your knees, chair pose. It's days like this that we love chair pose. The heat comes quick. Now, hands squeeze, feet spread, core engage. Feel it. Your body's in sync. Your body is one harmonious being. Sit a little deeper. That's it. Now push through your feet. Come on up. Stretch back because it feels good. And then bring your hands right into the heart. We're going to put it all together. Inhale, chair pose. Sit back, arms reach. Exhale, forward fold. Good. Lift on the inhale halfway. Go to plank and lower on the exhale. Both feet go back. Take it down slow. Keep feeling the integrations. Cobra pose. Exhale. Touch down dog and come into warrior one. The right foot steps up. The left foot turns in. Back foot is flat as you rise. Feel those pinky toes grounded. Exhale. Let's bring it right back down. Hands down. Step back and lower. This is what we call vinyasa. Inhale into cobra pose, and then exhale back to down dog. We're just touching down dog, and we move right into warrior on the left side. Left foot steps, right foot flat, rise on the inhale. And then on your exhale, you get to come right back down. Hands go down, step back lightly, and lower. All right, cobra on the in-breath. Don't rush. Exhale, down dog. Integrate and create every movement. All right. You get a few breaths here to sort of reconnect with yourself and your breathing.
Love is my religion.
Yeah, love is my religion.
Love is my religion.
Me and Ziggy. All right, a little integration, hands squeeze, feet spread, belly in, push back, inhale. Look at your hands. As you exhale, bring those feet to the top of the mat. Come halfway up, inhale. Then fold on the exhale. Bend those knees, here we go, chair pose. So what we just did was sun salutation B. It feels a little fast sometimes, it feels a little rushed sometimes, but it's purposeful. So I want to do it one more time, but I want you to do it in a way that makes you feel present, that you feel the actions in your body. Let's push into our feet, come to standing, reach for the sky, then exhale, bring the hands right to your heart. We're going to take a moment so you can get the rhythm of your own breath. Feel how long it takes for you to inhale and how long it takes for you to exhale. And then know that those movements are going to happen on those breaths. So if my cueing is a little fast for you, go slower. If my cueing is too slow for you, you can move faster. Your movement has to match your breath. Your breath doesn't match your movement. All right, so now that you feel the rhythm, on your inhale, take chair pose. One breath, sit down, arms reach. As soon as you're ready to exhale, you forward fold. On the inhale, you lift and lengthen. On the exhale, the feet go back and you lower. Empty, empty, empty your lungs. Inhale, cobra pose, a big deep breath. And then exhale to down dog and prepare for warrior. Right foot steps, left foot turns in, rise as you breathe in, reach for the sky. And when you're ready to exhale, you bring it right down. Hands down, step back and lower. That's it. Cobra pose on the in-breath. Down dog on the out-breath. Coming into warrior on the inhale, the left foot steps, the right foot turns, we rise, reach for the sky, and then exhale, bring it right back down. Hands down, step back, lower. Good. Inhale, cobra. Exhale all the way back to down dog, and I won't make you do that again, so if you're starting to get frustrated, don't worry. All right. Find your steady breath. When we start using those muscles, the heart rate comes up. And right now, you can actually start to even yourself out. Let's take one more breath and push back. And then as you exhale, look forward. Bring your feet to the top of the mat. Come halfway up on the in-breath. And then fold on the exhale. Here we go. Bend your knees. Sweep your arms to the sky. It's one breath in chair pose. And then come to standing and draw the hands right into your heart. Now check in for a moment. How do you feel? Feel pretty good? Do you feel a little warmer? And that heat is coming from inside of you. That is what yoga does. It gets us to create what we need in our bodies, in our minds, in our spirits. Let's lift our hearts a little higher as we start to move into some of our other poses. We're going to take a deep breath in, reach our arms up high to the sky. Then exhale, fold in low. This time let your head down. Good. I want you to soften your knees, keep your fingers on the floor, and then just step the right leg back. Right leg is going to step back and then put the heel down like a warrior foot. Nice, right there. Both feet are grounded. And then walk your hands to the inside of your left foot. Everybody okay there? Make sure you step back far enough that your hips aren't way up in the air. All right. So both hands are on the inside. Now I want you to turn and look out to your right and start to walk your hands off your mat. Just walk out. Uh-huh, right there. Right here. Yep. So walk. Don't turn your feet. Don't turn your feet. Just walk your hands forward. Mm-hmm. As your hands press forward, push your hips back. Just feel what's going on in there. Can you feel a little squeeze in your legs? Uh-huh. Some of you look really happy about this, some not so much. Keep your feet on the ground. Don't walk your hands so far that you lost the base of your pose. All right, now you're going to walk the hands back to the inside of that left ankle, and you're going to grab your ankle with both hands. Go under. From the inside. Yep, there you go. Put that left shoulder under the left knee and grab your ankle from either side. There you go. Now, sink your hips in a little more because you can. Uh-huh. Ooh, I like it, you guys. Take one more breath. Keep your cool. And then release your hands. You're just going to pivot up onto the right toes and step your left foot back to plank. I bet you never thought you'd be so happy to be in a plank pose. That's right. Hold steady right there. Reintegrate your body. Hands squeezed, feet spread, belly in. And then lift your hips and go to down dog. Oh, happiness is down dog. Who'd have ever thought? Let's walk our hands back to our feet now. Go to the back of the mat. Hands walk back to the feet. That's it. All right, the feet should be about hip distance apart here. We're going to bend the knees 90 degrees and reach the arms forward. So sink the hips and reach the arms forward. Again, you can feel your hips going back and your arms and your chest reaching forward. Let's get the chest and the belly right over the thighs. Get low. Mm-hmm. Maybe the gaze is at the front edge of your mat. That's it. You got this. Turn your feet straight. Yep. And then send your hips back and your arms forward. So you feel like a back and a forward. That's it. Take one more breath. And then just forward fold. Keeping those knees a little soft, tuck your chin and your tailbone and we'll come up like a rag doll. Knees are a little soft here because we don't want any pulling on the lower back. Stack your spine one vertebra at a time until you're standing up tall. You know, I have a little pink in your face now. It looks good. Inhale, arms reach. Exhale, forward fold. Walk it out into plank pose. Inhale. And then lower it down onto your belly as you exhale. Inhale for a gentle cobra pose. And then exhale back into downward facing dog. Now the right foot's going to step forward. The left foot's going to stay flat. And you're going to move both hands to the inside of your right foot. You can widen your stance a little bit, but before we do any of those crazy variations, I want you to actually get both feet grounded. Feel the base of the pose. Feel the work in the pinky toes. And then I want you to sort of aim for the left corner of your mat and start walking the hands out a little bit. Just walk them out toward the corner. Don't go so far that you lose your ground. You got to feel your hips pushing back and your arms reaching forward. Get some extension in your spine. Breath is steady. Hands are flat or on fingertips, but make sure you feel some connection to the earth. None of this is happening by accident. You are creating the shape, the action in your body. Now, we've created some space in those hips. We're going to walk the hands back in. Try to walk your right shoulder under your right knee and then grab that right ankle with both hands. Can you bend the front knee a little deeper and drop your hips down?
Take me to your river.
You gotta hang out, Lise. We like the same music. All right, are you breathing? Don't let any part of you give up. Take one last breath here. And then walk your hands back onto the mat. Pivot up onto your left toes. Step back to plank and hold. Ah. Belly to the spine. Hands squeeze a little. Feet spread a little. Feel the pinky toes. And then lift those hips and go to down dog. Press it back gently. Make sure you're breathing.
As my sins flow,
and then very simply walk your hands back to your feet.
Oh, I wanna come here and
now, when you get back there, open the feet a touch wider and turn your toes out. We're going to come into what we call malasana, a deep squat at the back of the mat. So feet are wide. It makes sense to take the feet apart. You might even be able to get the feet flat if they go wide enough. And then wedge your elbows inside your knees and bring your hands into prayer position. Now, as the elbows squeeze the knees out, I want you to squeeze the knees into the elbows. So you have a push and a pull going on. And then it's really easy to get heavy in the pelvis here. Like, you could just sit in this pose, right? That would be a break. But we're still in the middle of our practice, so there's an activation here. Squeeze your feet together, pull the pelvic floor up, and then lengthen your spine. Yeah, I like that better. Now see if you can walk down a little bit lower so you have more like your elbows past your knees and your shoulders are a little closer to your knees. And then see if you can lift your hips a little higher. Uh-huh. That's it. Keep your elbows pushing out. Now extend your arms out wide and see if you can touch your fingers to the floor. Now, as those fingers go out wide, can you lengthen the chest up? You guys are amazing. Just remember this feeling. Lift your hips a little more behind you. Remember this feeling. It's making an impression in you. And then let your hips down. Bring your hands back to center. And we're going to exit the pose really slowly. Hands down, bottoms up. Start to straighten your legs.
Please let me know.
Oh.
Take me to
Once
your
again,
river.
Like the rag doll, the knees soften. Tuck your tailbone in your chin and just come on up slowly. Roll it up one vertebra at a time. The belly is supporting the spine as you stack it. That's it. Inhale, arms reach for the sky. Exhale, they draw right back into the heart. Check in with yourself. How do you feel? You guys okay? All right. We're ready to move. Inhale, arms reach. Keep the belly in as you forward fold. Lift and lengthen on your inhale. Look forward and then walk it out to plank pose. Let's take a breath here together and then use the exhale to lower down slowly. Inhale, cobra pose. Exhale, down dog. All right, right foot steps up. Stay on your left toes this time. Come into high crescent lunge. Arms sweep up over the head. And then turn to your left and put that back heel flat as you open up for warrior two. So turn open to the left, the back foot flattens, and the arms open wide. Nicely done. Draw the belly to the spine. Feel the pinky toes press down and out, the arches of the feet lift. All right, left arm drops to left leg, right arm reaches for the sky. We call it reverse warrior, exalted warrior. There's a lot of names for it. I call it, it feels so good. Yeah, reach your fingers to the sky like you mean it. Lengthen up, don't just sink down. Now, pull the belly to the spine and then release your left arm out behind you. Let it float out like you want to reach for your neighbor behind you. Uh-huh, keep opening the chest, keep that breath flowing free, and then return to warrior two. You've got this. All right, right forearm onto the right thigh. Try not to lean. Push down to rise up. We're going to keep that left arm straight up to the sky. So sometimes we go over the ear, but today we're going to keep it straight up so the chest is wide open. And then try to draw the tailbone down slightly. As the tailbone draws down, that front knee can open a touch wider. Uh-huh, I like what I see. Now take the left arm, wrap it around behind your back. Press your arm or your hand into your own body and keep the chest wide open. Now, I want you to start to straighten your right arm and reach your fingertips toward the floor. Now, a lot of you were able to touch the floor, and you're leaning on your hands, so I'm going to make it just a touch harder. I want you to use the space between your legs. I want you to pull in that pelvic floor and just float right off the fingertips. Hold that yourself, because right now, we're going to release the left arm up and take a breath, and then exhale, return to warrior two. Oh, you've got it. Beautiful. Let's flow. Both hands go down. Step back to plank and lower slowly. Get back in the rhythm of your breath. Inhale for cobra. Exhale, move to down dog. Belly in, supporting the spine. Push through your hands. Reach through your heels. Just let your body love the pose. Let's all take a clearing breath. One big inhale. Make a sound on the exhale. Sometimes we just gotta let it out. I didn't hear you. What was that? Inhale. So much better. Nobody else wants to hear it all day long, right? All right, left foot steps up, stay on your right toes. Inhale, arms sweep up for high crescent lunge. Now we're gonna turn to the right, pivot the back foot flat. It's called warrior two, chest open wide. Check in with your body. Feel those pinky toes on the ground. Lift the arches of your feet. You've got this. Sometimes, because the groins are tight, we don't really want to stretch across the front of the body, so we stick our booty out. Everyone stick your booty out a little bit. You can feel the softening of the groins, right? But you can feel a little compression in the lower back. So I'd rather you draw the tailbone down a little bit, and it's okay to have a little pulling here as long as we don't have compression here. We can work with tension. We don't want to work with compression. So I want to make sure that you guys are safe. Now, right arm drops to right leg. Left arm goes to the sky. Reach up like you mean it. Call it whatever you want to. Just make sure it feels really good. Now, as you reach high, can you sink in a little lower? Bend the front knee. Keep feeling your pinky toes and your pinky fingers. And then the right arm, reach it out behind you. Just stretch it out to your neighbor behind you and feel how strong you are in your core. That is so beautiful. Return to warrior two. Do it with some grace. And then come to side angle pose. The forearm onto the thigh. And then keep that left arm high. Sorry, right arm high. Try not to lean onto the left arm. Instead, push down to rise up. That's it. Right arm is going to wrap around behind your back. And use the back of your hand to press into your body, or your forearm to press into your body, so you open your chest even more. The tailbone draws down. Even if the groins pull a little bit, it's better than the lower back getting crunched. And then left arm is going to start reaching toward the ground on the inside of that left foot. And it's okay if you put it down. Maybe you have to just get your bearings. But then I want that integration to happen. Squeeze a little bit between the pelvic floor, like right up in that lower belly. Lengthen your spine. Draw the head back and see if you can get a float happening right over the fingertips, right? Like right over the mat. Just, yeah, see if you can hold that. I know, that's work. Don't make a face. Extend your arm up to the sky. Take a breath. And then exhale with everything you are. Woo! Make your way back to warrior two. All right, here we go. Let's flow it out. Both hands go down. Step back lightly. Lower down slowly. Inhale for cobra pose. And then exhale back to down dog. All right. Now, walk your hands to the back of the mat. Open those feet a little wider. Come back into that really nice squat that we were doing before. And we're going to just go right back into the place where we were. Right? So we were not just elbows in the knees, but we slid down by the triceps. And you can feel it. There's a little space between the arm muscle and the shoulder muscle. There's like a little space there. I want you to aim for that spot. Yeah. Feels good to press into that spot. And then your hands are going to go on the floor right in front of you, not out wide. And feel that same thing. Knees squeeze in, arms push out. Then rock your weight forward into your hands. Look forward. And then drop back where you were before. We're going to rock three times. So we're going to rock into our hands. You can even get up on your tippy toes. Look forward. And then sink back. Yep, do that at least three times. And then after the third one, make sure your knees are squeezing your arms and see if you can just bend your right knee and lift your right foot from the floor. Mm-hmm. Keep that lift, that squeeze. That's it. Put it down. Rock back. And then do it again. Rock forward. Squeeze those knees in. See if you can lift your left foot. Yep. You can feel what's happening inside. When you break it down and you make impressions, sometimes we can then put it all together. Go ahead, rock forward, squeeze your knees in, see if you can bend the knees a little more, lift both feet, keep looking forward. It's called bakasana. It's fun. It's fun to try. Yes, you guys are amazing. Look how many people are flying. Woohoo! Let us celebrate in each other's successes, yeah? All right, go ahead, put your feet back down if you're still flying, and then come on into a forward fold. Lift your bottom, straighten your legs. All right, inhale, look up and lengthen. Exhale, fold. Bend your knees, roll up slowly like a rag doll. This is a moment for reintegration. The feet push out, the belly pulls in, and we rise up until we're standing really tall. Roll your shoulders back. Hold your head high. Let's inhale and reach for the sky. Exhale, draw it right into your hand, your hands right into your heart. Take a moment right here and just notice how you feel. Now I invite you to open your eyes and just look around. Look at how many people are here today. Look how many people in our community feel just like you do about coming out on a beautiful day, being with other people and doing something really good for yourself. We are not alone. We are so much more alike than we realize. In this moment, it doesn't matter what kind of job you have or if you don't have one. In this moment, we are just humans, human beings with big, wide open hearts, feeling good. Really amazing. As you look around, could you smile? Imagine how even that could lighten someone else's day, right? It is amazing how much we can support each other and connect. Let's take one more vinyasa together. Let's do it with the spirit of this connection. Inhale, arms reach. Exhale, go ahead, forward fold. Lift and lengthen. Inhale, look forward. Walk it out into plank pose. And lower yourself nice and slow all the way down. Inhale, cobra. And back to down dog on the exhale. That's it. Push back just a little. Make sure you're breathing. Now, right foot steps forward to the hands. And then the left knee is going to drop down softly. I want you to walk your right foot over to the left side. I'm just going to do a time check. Perfect. And then drop the right knee toward the right side of the mat and come into pigeon. But we're going to come in a little bit different today. We're going to do a little integration work before we just sink and melt in. So lower onto your forearms. I want you to feel your elbows on the floor right under your shoulders and then start squeezing the forearms toward each other. You'll feel the chest activate. You'll feel the belly activate. Now tuck your left toes and lift your left knee. That's it. Now start squeezing a little bit on your outer hips and draw your belly button to your spine. You can lower your gaze down to your fingertips. That's it. I want you to feel all of that muscle work. There is nothing at ease here. We are working. That's it. Core work at its finest. The shin is down and the elbows are down. See if you can get that. Drop onto your forearms. Elbows. Yeah, there you go. And you don't have to lift this. Tuck this and lift this. Yes, there you go. Got it now? Yeah. So a little bit of heat building, yeah? A little bit of aggravation building, maybe? Take a deep breath in. Feel how strong you are. Feel how amazing this moment is. How much your muscles are hugging your bones and your body is so integrated. It feels like one action, one piece, one holistic being. And then when you are ready, we're going to soften it. So go ahead, put the back knee down, start to widen your elbows, see if you can lay your head down. And just keep feeling that energy dissipate. Gripping or holding anywhere in your body, just give yourself permission to let it down, let it release. We're only going to take three more breaths here, so just let your body feel, let the tension melt. Don't poke it, don't force it, don't avoid it, just be with it. Now we've got to be really careful as we come out. We're going to walk our hands back and under our shoulders. Tuck your left toes so you can start to lift your hips. And then take that right leg out from under you and stretch it up to the sky. And if you want to make a sound, please do. Do not hold that in. Yes, that is the tension that was built up in there. Let it go. Let it out. Open that hip wide to the sky. Look under your right arm. Stretch like it's good to be alive. Love your body in this moment. Take one more breath and then go ahead and put that foot back on the mat. Inhale, push back. Exhale, come forward into plank and lower down slow. Inhale, cobra pose. Exhale, downward facing dog. Now we got the other side. Left foot steps up, right knee goes down. That's it. Wiggle your left foot to the right side of the mat so that you can take your left knee down. The left knee stays toward the left side of the mat. Please don't bring it to the midline. That's it. And then lower onto your forearms. Squeeze those forearms toward each other so the chest broadens and the muscles start to activate. Tuck your right toes under, lift your right knee, and then squeeze a little on your outer hips. You might even feel your left hip move back and your right hip move forward. That belly is to the spine, and we're doing it all in equal measure. It's not like just the arms are squeezing and the leg is heavy behind you. We have to find that way to spread the effort out evenly. So it's more about consciousness and awareness than it is about how hard you work. We're paying attention. We're being in relationship with our tension. We're being in relationship with our bodies, our minds, our attitudes. We are looking for ways to create equanimity, balance. And it comes through our efforts. How hard do we push? How soft are we? Take one more breath here, feel it, and then watch it melt away as you start to lower yourself back in. And you might find that there's some resistance in there. As you start to lower down, the body goes, ooh, I'm not sure I like that. So you've got to be in relationship with that too. Don't force. Don't force. See if you can give yourself permission to relax a little more deeply. When the yoga helps us to discover,
do you
the tension that lives in the depths of our body. How do we treat it?
They drew out a map and they showed you direction, your sender.
If the pose gets a little confrontational, how do you handle it?
My love is just a reminder, find your center. My love is just a reminder, find your center. My love is just a reminder. My love is just a reminder, find your center.
We're gonna take our last three breaths here.
Light at dawn and cracks on the floor. Well, it served as a warning. Everything's changing.
Be in them fully.
So familiar.
Let yourself feel it all.
Hopped in the car.
Feel that breath moving through your body. The blood coursing through your veins. Acknowledge how good it is to be alive. And then with some grace and with some respect, let's walk our hands back up into under our shoulders. Use the hands, press a little bit, tuck your right toes so your hips begin to lift and you can free the left leg and take it all the way up into the sky. Yes, stretch it way up high. You can even open the hip a little wider and look under your left arm. Stretch your body because it feels good. Do this because you can. I love it. When you feel ready, that foot goes back on the mat. Together, let's inhale and push back. And then exhale, come forward to plank and lower down slow. Inhale into your cobra pose. And then exhale, take it back to down dog. This is your last down dog of the practice, so feel it. The hands squeeze, the belly draws in, the legs press back, heels sinking, pinky toes reaching. Take your last breath here, and then come into a seated position. You can jump, step, walk, crawl, drop, drag, whatever works for you. Bring your feet around in front of you. Bend your knees and put your feet onto the mat. I want you to open your feet about hip distance apart because then it'll make it feel just a little bit more natural for your body. And we're going to integrate. We're going to feel the footprints press down and drag your heels back towards you without actually moving your feet. You can feel it. It's like this squeeze. It's your hamstrings. We don't always have to stretch them. Sometimes we gotta squeeze them, right? So the feet are like pulling back toward the sit bones. Now sit up tall. Sit up as straight as you can. Lift up through your spine. See if you can extend your arms in front of you. It's so good. Now keep the action in the legs and the feet. Keep the action in your core. Clasp your hands together. Turn your body to the right just a little. Feel the obliques activate. Doesn't take much. Now, I really like what I see. There's one little tweak I would love to offer for you. Can you draw the chest a little more forward and draw the shoulder heads back? You'll feel your collarbones widen, right? Feels like the chest just broadened. Now take one more breath and use your exhale to twist deeper. Good, face forward. And take it to the other side. You don't have to go far to get that first action.
Looking in the mirror.
And then holding that is where you're gonna get your strength from. Are your feet still grounded? Are you still dragging your heels back? How's that belly button doing? Is it into the spine? Are we able to do all of these things in equal measure? Can you spread the consciousness away from one action and into all of the actions? Approach yourself as if you are one being, not just feet or just belly. I like it. Now, shoulder heads back, chest broadens. We're going to do one more breath. Use the exhale to twist in just a little more. And then face forward. Let's release the hands, turn the palms to face up, start to tuck your chin. You'll feel your back round. Let the tailbone tuck under you. and very slowly, one vertebra at a time, lay it down onto your back. Use that core. Keep your feet grounded. Keep squeezing the back of your knees. You lay it down nice and slow. All right. Draw the right knee into your belly. As the right knee draws in, start pushing out through your left heel so you feel a little action in both sides of the pelvis. Push and pull. Good. Now keep anchoring down. I want you to focus on the action of your left leg. Right? Keep pushing out through the left heel and then lift your head, neck, and shoulders from the mat. Uh-huh. Can you release your right knee now and reach forward? Uh-huh, right there. Now for three breaths, we're going to squeeze a little bit on every exhale. One big inhale here, squeeze a little tighter on the exhale. I know you can do it. Knee to chest, chest to knee. One more time, breathe in and then squeeze on the exhale. Ooh, yeah, we got to build some heat before Shavasana. One more time, squeeze it in. Lift, lift, lift those shoulder blades off the mat and then release, lay it down. Good. Give your knee one more squeeze and then take a twist over to your left side. All that heat. Feel it dissipate. Open your chest wide. Look out to the right.
I live for the spirit I am. I live for the spirit I am.
Make sure you're breathing. We start to slow down some of the actions. It's okay to work really hard as long as we can acknowledge ourselves and allow ourselves to be soft. Make sure your right arm is reaching out toward the ground. Let your chest be open wide. Better? Let's take one more breath right here where you are. And then very slowly roll it back to center. If it feels good, give yourself one more squeeze with that right knee and then simply switch. Go ahead and pull the left knee into the belly. Extend the right one out. Extend it out like you mean it. Start flexing your feet. Feel the action of the right leg. And then come on up. Lift head, neck, and shoulders. And you got to do that from the core. Imagine your hips and your ribs are drawing toward each other. Feel where that's coming from. And then release your arms forward. Try not to strain your neck. You can keep looking at the sky. Now we're doing three big breaths. Big inhale. Squeeze it in on the exhale. See if you can get in a little tighter. One more breath. It's going to open you back up. And then squeeze it back in. One more time. Feel it, the heat, the strength, the activation. Last time, squeeze. And then lay your head back down. Take your twist over to the right. Your arms can be on the ground. There's a really nice rotation through your spine. And I want you to allow yourself to breathe free. Allow yourself the privilege to soften a little bit. If we continue to grab onto the bones and hug the muscles, we're not opening up the opportunity for the tension to leave. It's in the softening that the stuff that we break through, the stuff that we touch, the stuff that we massage, it's in these soft moments at the end that it gets to leave us. Go ahead and gently roll back to the center. If you want to squeeze that knee one more time, go ahead, do it. And then if you would, bend both knees and put your feet on the floor. Arms by your sides. I want you to push down into your feet and squeeze your heels towards your bottom and then start lifting your hips off the ground. Push down into your arms so you get the chest to rise a little more. Take a big inhale and then exhale, bring it down. Upper back, middle back, lower back. two more times like that. Inhale, rolling bridges. Lift your hips high. Exhale, bring it down. Upper back, middle back, lower back. Last one, best one right here. Push down to rise up. Squeeze a little bit. Get as much space in the front body as you can. And then take it down slow. Upper back, middle back, lower back. Both knees draw in one last time. Give yourself a little squeeze. Rock a little side to side. Make sure everything's feeling good. If you want to grab onto your shirt, if you took your sweatshirt off while you were moving, this might be a really good time to grab it. You can cover yourself or put it back on. If you're lucky enough to have a little bit of rays of the sun on you, just soak them in. And then we're going to find our way right into Shavasana. Shavasana is our final resting pose. From the outside, it seems like the easiest one we do. It's actually the most profound. To lay in stillness. To literally just be with yourself in your own skin. To bear witness to yourself, no longer doing anything, but instead just allowing yourself to be. Maybe we get reintroduced to our true self, to our humanity, to the things that live within us that are so much like everyone else. And maybe we even start to recognize the things about us that are unique. What our gifts are, how we might bring those gifts forth in the world. And it's not because you try, it's not because you're thinking about it, it's because you open yourself up to the stillness and you allow these awarenesses to come to you. So put away the actions. Step away from your thoughts. Meet yourself right here, where you are in this moment. Just you and your breath. Start to let the breath return to the body. Let the breath be the first part of your awakening. And then put your attention, your consciousness, right onto the breath. And feel your conscious awareness move through your body. If you feel ready to move, you can. You can move and stretch in any way that really suits you. I want you to feel whole, not separate from the breath, your being in your body, the movements, your state of mind, any of it. I want it to all be in union. That is what yoga is. And eventually, as you begin that awakening and you feel like you want to stretch and move, you can come to seated. You can sit any way you like. And I want you to take another moment and look around. Look at the softness in everybody's eyes. Look at the softness in each other's faces. This might be the only time today that you are surrounded by people that have this softness. Remember what it feels like. And then also remember that if you hold on to it, if each and every one of us holds on to it, then we take this and we spread it out. If we don't have the will, if we don't have the desire, if we don't even have the awareness that we could be this when we get up from the mat, then we lose it. But if we own this, if we have this idea that we can be this softness, we can be this generous, we can be this loving, we can be this, whatever this is for you, you might actually open up the door for somebody else to be it. Your softness can soften someone else, just like their hardness can harden you. So I leave you with the choice. We are way more powerful than we think we are. We have the ability to shift not just ourselves like we just did, but others around us just with our presence alone. Let's bring our hands together at the heart as if to seal that, and together we'll make the sacred sound of Om. It's a way for you to raise the vibration of your own body, for you to like make a commitment and seal this like as if it is a truth. So I'm actually going to, instead of hands in prayer, which doesn't resonate for everybody, I want you to put your left hand on your heart and then put your right hand on your left hand. So you can just feel the Om in your own self. That's it. Now, don't leave me hanging because I'm the only one with the mic. And so I want everyone at home, even if you have other people in the other room, I want them to hear you say that sound, that beautiful, sacred, universal sound. It's a U and an M. Ah, ooh, that's what it sounds like. Ah, it starts in your belly, it rises through the chest, and it culminates in the crown. It's you moving energy in your own body. You guys ready to do it with me? Do it with everything that you are. You don't have to sing well. You just have to make a sound. When you're ready, take a really big, deep breath. Ah. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shantihi. Om Peace, Peace, Perfect Peace. May you carry it in your hearts. May you find ways in which that you can be this peace in the world. May you recognize it in everyone else. It's in there. We all have it deep, deep inside of us. Start to open your eyes and look at your neighbors. You will, when you recognize it in yourself, you recognize it in them. That is exactly what I mean when I say to you, Namaste. The sacred, divine light that exists within me also exists in every single one of you. Thank you so much. Namaste. Namaste to all of you. Namaste. Have a wonderful Saturday. It's a beautiful day. Smile at others. Soften your eyes. I'm sure I have information for you. Passes to the studio. Yes, you can hug me. I love you. So I have passes for the studio. I have the clipboards. If you haven't signed in yet, there's a lot of you here today. I'm sure that you didn't all get a chance to sign in on the clipboards. Can you please come forward, come see me? It's so nice. The people who hide in the back, you always tell me, I come to the park all the time. And I say, well, I never see you. We don't have passes. I have some passes in my bag. So I do have some passes. I have some magnets. And registration is open. Please go online to somethingbigyoga.com. Please register. It's a free event on January 1st in Meisner Park Amphitheater. It's like this times 10. Is that right? Times 10?
Yeah.
Yes, this times 10. I'm bad at math. So we had 2,200 people doing yoga together on New Year's Day last year. This will be year number 6. Woo, right? That's so amazing. South Florida yoga is alive and well and thriving. So please come be part of that. It's being part of a community. It's an amazing morning. It's totally free. It is our give back to you for supporting us all year long and all the things that we do. So if you would like a pass to the studio, it's somethingbigyoga.com. Somethingbigyoga.com. Just go on. It's free. If you're pre-registered, it makes that day's entry so much easier for us. We have to have everyone sign a waiver. So if you're already registered online, the waiver has been released. If you get there and you're not registered, you have to sign in at the front desk, and then we have lines of people. So that's why we're asking for the pre-registration to make the day of smooth and steady. So somethingbigyoga.com. And then come see me. Come sign in. Sign up on my email list if you want to stay in touch. Okay. Yeah, I just need a pen. Oh, and today, one more thing. If anyone here is interested in teacher training, my next teacher training is going to start in February. The registration forms are already starting to pile in. I'm doing 2 this week, 2 open houses where we can just sit and ask questions. So right now I'm going to stay for about a half an hour after this practice. And I'm here to answer questions for you if you're curious about becoming a teacher, if you want to deepen your own practice. I only take small groups at a time, so if you want to do teacher training, come and see me. We're going to sit for a little while. We can get to know each other, and we can ask questions. And if you can't stay today, then Wednesday night, right after my class, I teach from 6 to 7:30. We're going to sit in the tea lounge for a little while after class and do the same. So open to answer your questions, to meet you, and to find out what you want to, how you want to explore your yoga, you know? So teacher training today or Wednesday night, passes to the studio, come sign in. This is the email list. There's the sign-in sheet. Yes.